So I have been privileged during this period to come and spend the lockdown at my parents' home in the township in Soweto. And what that really has done for me is that it's put me slam bang in the middle of the survivor audience. And I think the main key takeout that I've taken from this entire experience is that there's a lot of unlearning and learning that we need to be doing and making as brands to better communicate to the survivor audience in South Africa. And I think the key, you know, takeouts, or rather the key observations which I've made is that the first one is that brands need to be shouting less. There's quite a lot of information that is going out around healthcare, information around our economy, information around restrictions of the lockdown, etc., etc., etc. And really, this information overload to an audience that we've never really seen as critical thinkers and never really deemed as intellectuals. And I think we really need to move from the space of information overload to clear communication. Because what clear communication really means is I see you. It's layered with respect and it's extremely empathetic to an audience that not only, you know, deserves it, but really needs it the most and is the most vulnerable in our society. The other thing is that we need to embody their language, and embodying their language is having a good understanding of some of the critical challenges they face. Space is an issue. Really basic needs are an issue for them. And when we start understanding what that means, then we can better cater to them and better. And I think it's really imperative that we need to make changes that will last beyond the season. Changes that are not only just going to help them for the day to day, but changes that really will start helping them, you know, for the months and the years to come. Because at the core of them, these are South Africans that are contributors that want to be part of the greater change in our country.